Hello, it is the Angry Llama. 'Tis the season for giving, so the bipeds tell me. Give back, they say. It's the season, Llama. You can't stay angry all year, dude. Well, want to win a semester at the Llama Overwatch School? Yeah, you get 6 weeks of coaching from me, Alfred P. Llama. We'll meet for 1 hour per week. We'll identify your weaknesses, your strengths, and even give you a little bit of homework and some drills, and we all get to watch you climb on the channel. Well, how do you do it? Well, this is easy. You support the channel between now and January 1st, and I enter you into the random raffle to win the semester with me. Don't worry, if you're already an existing founding farmer, I did not doomfist you in the keister. You can also enter via the Discord. So all the existing members will go into one raffle, and all of the new members go into another raffle. I barely get one or two founding farmers a month, so if you enter the raffle, you've got a pretty good chance of winning the semester with Al, which is 6 weeks of climbing with your favorite angry llama. Okay, hello. Today, we have an oldie but a goodie. What's that mean? Well, this dude has been around for a long time. This is Bernie. Yeah, I once spent a weekend at his house. Lots of dead antics. He is in the 1235 rank. He's been there for 4 years. He got out for a spell, but now he's back down to bronze. His hero is Orisa. I ask him, how hard does he want to be roasted? He says, burn it all to the ground. Well, all right. What's holding you back? How much? I ask him what's holding you back. He responds with, how much time do you have? That's actually funny. He writes, I'm old, slow, game senses is lacking at times, and I play on a potato. Did I mention my aim sucks? I think everyone thinks their aim sucks, and it's like the last thing you have to get good at, I think. I don't know. Okay, so Bernie decides 2 days later to write a follow-up. Let's read this follow-up together. I just want to follow up on the submission and give a more thoughtful answer to what's holding you back. My main issue is battling all the... quote, this is how you play, quote, advice I've gotten over the years. Ooh, okay. I struggle trying to apply higher level concepts in low level games. And the dichotomy of knowing if I do X, we may win, but I need you to do Y under non-bronze conditions. Tanks are the most problematic for me in this regard. You know, honestly, I agree with you. I think some people feel like tanking is the easiest to climb on. I do not. I feel like you need the support of your team. And below a certain level, this game is simply deathmatch with some fun team aspects. Okay, so he writes, tanks are the most problematic for me in this regard. For instance, trying to take high ground positions when the rest of my teammates don't look up. Trying to target squishies when my teammates are expecting tanks to brawl on point. We need a shield, so on and so forth. Yeah, sure. I could say F it, get on Ryan, and swing my way back to silver. But I feel like there is something fundamental I still need to work on to be able to excel down the road, or in Overwatch 2 for that matter, and to be able to have multiple tanks in my toolkit. And I actually do like playing Orisa, so I'm weird, sorry. Don't be sorry. I love that battle cattle. I love her. Also, an Overwatch 40 player, I know, I'm not going to have the aim or the... I'm sorry. As an over 40 watch hashtag player, I know I'm not going to have the aim or reaction time a 20-year-old does, so I'm not trying to figure out where I can improve aside from not missing 80% of my shots in terms of using my character to change the meta of the match I'm in. How can I play, in this instance, Orisa, and be a factor that forces change from the other team? You know, I love the way you worded that. That's exactly what we're going to do. We're going to look at your game, and I'm not going to say, oh, your team needs to do this or your team needs to do that. I'm going to say what you could have done and what I personally would have done at your rank to make impact on Orisa.
It must be my day because Bernie Floyd is on the blue team, and that means the red team we get to shoot at. Oh, that makes a reviewer's job so much easier, I tell you. Yes, very good punching, but where are you gonna set up, you reindeer-looking motherfucker? You're gonna go high ground. Yes, so we're gonna shield what? Soldier, boosted soldier, I like that. All right, here's a tip. When you're in bronze, when you're in any rank, really, and you're not really doing comms, or not everybody's in comms, or not everybody's listening, my advice to you, and I do this, is you run up, put a shield where it's going to be at the start of the match. It gives everybody the heads up that the main tank is going to be there,
And don't worry, everybody. So don't run around and punch stuff. Don't you bait your team by going low ground and then running back to high ground, and then you wonder why people aren't with you. Be very consistent as a main tank in lower levels. People will follow you to the dance if they think you're not crazy and just going every which way. Be very steady. Walk up. Assume your position 10, 15 seconds early. Like, get right to your position. Assume it so everybody knows where their main tank is going to be. It helps them play better without any sort of communication. Everybody can give that a go in bronze. You don't know how to shield stack? I don't think you know how to shield stack. That's okay. I'm going to put a link right below here on the shield stacking 1 minute or 2 minute tutorial I did. They're called the Llama Lessons. Shield stacking is very important on Orisa. It alone will get you further.
One. Attackers incoming.
Wow, dude. What are you, a fucking dickhead? What are you doing? Bernie, why weren't you even in the fucking fight, bro? You're the main tank. They're all waiting for you. You're the leader. And then you put your shield in front of you. What the fuck? Like, at least put it here so we can do work so D.Va can reach out. But you put it back here? That's just weird, man. And now Soldier can't peek out. Like, everyone's got, like, no sights on it. Bernie, I'm already not loving this. Like, important things are positioning and using your shield. The aim looks fine, but move. Shield. As Orisa, your shield, I know you think it's for you, it's not. You need to put that shield out immediately when it's available. But why? I wasn't taking any damage, Llama. It's not about you! You're in charge of the team, man! You're like Papa Bear. You gotta keep everybody safe. When people die on your team, you should fucking feel bad. Oh, fuck, what could I have done? You're in charge of protecting people. It's called a tank.
Dude.
Awful fortify. Awful. All right. I'm not... I've already stopped it 3 times, and I'm sorry. But there's a general rule that I'd like to get out to you that's very easy. If you're getting pushed somewhere you don't want to go, or you're getting CC'd in some way that you don't want to be CC'd, fortify, great. Otherwise, if you're using it for damage reduction, wait until all of your yellow health is gone. That's armor. So wait until all your yellow health's gone, then you're allowed to hit fortify. But fortify is a huge fucking cooldown that you just willy-nillied. I bet in the next 10 seconds you might actually need it to live. So we dropped off. What are you doing? You are fundamentally playing this character wrong. I'm going to take a real quick quiz. What is Orisa good at? Yeah. Neural Cindy in the back. Protect? Sure. Shields. Sure. Sure. That's right, shields. And does Orisa's damage have any fall off, Golgar? No, right. Orisa's damage has no fall off. What's that mean? That means you can be as far away as you want and still be doing the same damage. Well, why does that matter? Because half of the heroes in the game have to be next to you to do damage. So it behooves you, and I mean that like a llama. Hooves on it, so good. It behooves you to literally be as far away from the fight as humanly fucking possible while still having an impact and protecting your team. You are just walking towards people. It's literally insane. Not shielding your team. Halt! Halt! You can walk up on that Orisa now, though. I mean, your D.Va's doing it right. Give them a shield. Give them a shield. Post-it note one. I'm going to give you 3 things you're going to work on, and you're going to fucking climb. This is an easy one, man. You are making, like, super bronze mistakes, and this is going to super help you. You ready? Okay. The first one I need you to do is put a post-it note on your monitor that says, is my shield protecting my team? Is my shield protecting my team? You're only using it for yourself. You need to have a paradigm switch. What's that mean? A switch in thought. You need to think that your shield is not for you. You need to understand that it is for your team. Anytime you can shoot that shield from downtown and put it in front of your team while you're still moving your slow-ass battle cattle head there, you should. You should.
It's almost always, like, worthless to halt the ball. He gets away. Like, don't use it for ball. Don't even worry about ball. Guys, ball is... ball is there to distract you. Don't let him. He's not having impact. Just fucking leave him be and shoot stuff in front of you. If your healers are dying to him, then fine. But they're not. He's a bad ball. It's on you to decide whether or not he gets your attention. And if he gets your attention and that takes it off from your friends, then I guess he's doing his job. Put your shield up! Holy shit! You have a gadding Mercy and you're not even trying to protect her.
Okay. I've got your number to post it. I've got your number to post it. Use your halt more. Use your halt more. I want to find, it was a great video. I don't want to have to redo it. But basically, you can halt them at like a 45 degree angle. Like you put the, you put the halt orb above, say, their right shoulder 2 to 3 feet above it. You know they're going to basically make a triangle. They're going to go up at an angle and then come back down. So you can actually practice this in the training room. You know what? And I'll show you that at the end of the video. Fuck it. I'll show it to you. But we need you to do better halts and use halts for more than what you think they're used for. And again, a paradigm shift. Use halts to secure kills. Like back in the day, halt pulled really far. You can pull people into wells, pull them out. But now it's really pulling them into bad positions. Even if they're out in the open, in bronze, you sometimes have a hard time hitting them, right? Not when you halt them. Use that to counteract your bronze aiming. Use the halt to make the kills easier to secure. I'll show you in a training room right after this. Let me find the third thing you can work on first. No. Waste of time. Well, what could you be doing? I personally would have shield stacked here, and remember, I'll link that. Shit, you know what? Maybe I'll just show that. Fuck it. That's your third thing, shield stacking. I'm just going to show you. I'm going to show you the training room. I'm going to show you shield stacking, and you're going to have to learn to use your shield for people. That is plenty. Come back in 4 weeks and show me you're doing those three things, and I'll give you the three next tips. The Angry Llama is made for adults who enjoy honest, crass, cutting reviews when we're talking fucking llama. Sensitive bipeds need not apply.
Llama lessons focus on one ability at a time. We deep dive and we talk about that single ability. Today is the Orisa Barrier. The barrier is on a 10-second cooldown. It lasts for 20 seconds or 600 damage, whichever comes first. In this video, I am going to show you some cool tips and tricks, but mostly on defense, how to get 3 shields up when most Orisas only get 2. The cooldown begins immediately. This will become important in a moment. You can shoot your barrier into matrix, deflect, or kinetic grasp. It does not matter. It's still your barrier. And the barrier can be deployed while reloading. This is also very important to know. Now, let's look at a specific example that works great on King's Row. You put your shield down with 10 seconds remaining. So when the door opens, your cooldown is up. Then, when the enemy rounds the corner, the moment they start doing damage, you shoot a shield into the air directly perpendicular to yourself, 90 degrees up. Then you shoot. Once the barrier breaks, you can fortify, hold it. Now your new barrier is down. Now look at your cooldown. Now, next barrier. That's 3 barriers where most Orisas get 2. In low elos, this will mess with them quite a bit. They won't understand how they can't get through your shields. Add Orion or a Sigma to that, and you will own point A for the rest of your being. You're very welcome. Hopefully you learned something new you can use on your Orisa and enjoy a more satisfying defense.
We're trying to secure a kill, but it's hard. So we throw the orb up here and we follow him up and down. Ready? Let's do it again. You put it up above him, you follow him up and down.
Look at the damage you can do. When you get good, you can do the head. But let's just set him up again. So you can be even way over here, right? So we got our shield up. We're fucking with him, put above his head. We click. We follow him up. We follow him down. And they can't do anything. They are going to be on a path that you know. So you don't have to be fast at aiming. You don't have to be young. You have to be fucking smart. So you're going to put the orb up there. And now I know their path. So I'll just shoot at it. Boom. Like, use the tools in your toolbox. You don't have speed, and you certainly don't have a 7-foot erection that can bang a 6-inch spike through a board, but a girl has to have standards.
I'm sorry I didn't get a chance to know you at all. I can't stand it. Have you ever seen a body like this before in your life?
She happened to be my daughter.
Oh, well, then I guess you have.
Coming down?
Yeah. No, seriously, listen, if there's ever anything I can do for you, or more to the point, to you, you let me know, okay?
Can you hammer a 6-inch spike through a board with your penis?
Not right now.
A girl's gotta have her standards.
All right.
Llama!
Do you want to climb with the llama? Then you gotta join the farm! Only 30% of the llama's viewers are subscribed. What horror! How can you expect to climb without the llama's daily bother of viewers? Okay, hit your hooves on that sub button. We'll continue like none of this ever happened.